हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज एटॉमिक वॉल्यूम और एटॉमिक साइज। देन लेट अस कंप्लीट फर्स्ट एटॉमिक वॉल्यूम और एटॉमिक साइज। द वॉल्यूम ऑक्यूपाइड बाई 1 ग्राम एटम ऑफ एन एलिमेंट इन सॉलिड स्टेट इन सीसी सेंटीमीटर क्यूब और क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटर इज कॉल्ड एटॉमिक वॉल्यूम ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट। हेंस दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ग्राम एटॉमिक वॉल्यूम। वंस अगेन, वॉल्यूम ऑक्यूपाइड बाय 1 ग्राम एटम ऑफ एन एलिमेंट इन सीसी सेंटीमीटर क्यूब इन सॉलिड स्टेट is called atomic volume of that element, and this is also known as gram atomic volume. We can write in the formula form atomic volume equal to atomic mass divided by density. Atomic mass by density. Now second point, gram atomic mass. What is this? And 1 gram atom. 1 gram atom. 1 gram atom of an element is actually that quantity of element which weighs equal to the ग्राम एटॉमिक मास ऑफ एलिमेंट। ग्राम एटॉमिक मास ऑफ एलिमेंट इज कॉल्ड 1 ग्राम एटम। लाइक ग्राम एटॉमिक मास ऑफ सोडियम इज 23 ग्राम, देन 23 ग्राम ऑफ सोडियम इज नोन एज 1 ग्राम एटम ऑफ सोडियम। कार्बन एटॉमिक मास 12 ग्राम, देन इट इज 1 ग्राम एटम। 1 ग्राम एटम ऑफ कार्बन इक्वल टू 12 ग्राम ऑफ कार्बन, एंड हेंस this 1 gram of atom contains how many atoms? It contains 1 mole atoms, 6.022 10 power 23 atoms, 1 gram atom. 1 gram atom means 6.022 10 power 23 atoms. These many atoms, 1 gram atoms, these many atoms. Mass of 1 gram atom, mass of these many atoms. Then atomic volume is actually the volume of these many atoms of element. Now atomic volume equal to volume of 6.022 into 10 power 23 atoms. Volume of these many atoms is called atomic volume of that element. Now, if you want to calculate the volume of one atom of element, then volume of one atom equal to atomic volume. Atomic volume means volume of these many atoms divided by Avogadro number. This is also known as Avogadro number. 6.022 into 10 power 23. Atomic volume divided by this is the volume of one atom of element. Now periodic trend. Periodic trend. Atomic volume of elements. So periodic trend in the periodic table. First, down the group, on moving down the group, like lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, these are the first group element. On moving down the group, atomic size almost increases down the group. Reason, due to successive increase in the number of cells. When number of cell increases, atomic volume of the element increases. How it is? In lithium, how many cells are there? In lithium only, this is nucleus, 2 cells are there. In sodium, how many cells are there? 3 cells are there. Potassium, 4. Rubidium, 5. Cesium, 6 cells, like that. And francium, 7 cells are there in francium. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. How many cells are there? 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like that, total 7 cells are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cells are there. Due to successive increase in the number of cells, size of volume of the element increases. Now, we can see some, with the help of some calculation, like lithium, around 13 in cc, I am telling 13.1, sodium around 23.7, potassium around 45.2, and rubidium around 55.8, cesium 70, and francium around 87 cc, their atomic volume. Now let us see variation of atomic volume across a period. On moving across a period, here is beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon, like this. Second element in this, beryllium. On moving across a period, atomic volume first decreases to minimum value, then increases. This is happening with the atomic volume across a period. Why? Once decreasing, then increasing. Because of difference in the close packing of atoms in different arrangement. Different elements have different close packing of different arrangement of atoms. This is why it is observed there across a period. Now, variation of atomic volume across a period depends on two factors. First, nuclear charge. Nuclear charge, and second one, valence electron. Valence electron. On moving across a period from left to right, nuclear charge increases with the increase in atomic number. As a result, nuclear pull on the outer electron increases, because effective nuclear charge is increasing, then nuclear pull attraction on outer electron increases, atomic volume must decrease across a period. Second factor, valence electron. On moving across a period from left to right, from lithium to the last up to this one, number of valence electron increases in the same cell. Number of cell remains same. This period, lithium, beryllium, like lithium, atomic number 3, then how many cells are there? Only 2 cells are there. All these elements have only 2 cells, but the number of electron is increasing in the same cell, like beryllium. That outermost cell is having, second cell is having 2 electron. Boron, second cell is having 3 electron. Now see, 4, atomic number 5, atomic number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here, in this, second cell is having 2 electron, here 3 electron, here 4 electron, 5 electron, 6 electron, 7 electron, here second cell is having 7 electrons, see nucleus, first cell is having 2, but second cell is having how many electron? 7 electron in the cell, and here 1 electron. Then like that, number of electron is increasing here in the same cell. Number of valence electron increasing means electrons are having similar charge, like charges, and like charges repel each other. Then because of increase in the number of electrons in the same cell, inter-electronic repulsion, strong inter-electronic repulsion is there if the valence cell is having more number of electrons. Because of this inter-electronic repulsion, size of the volume of the atom must increase. Then these two contradictory properties, increase in nuclear charge results the decrease of atomic volume, but increase in valence electron in the same cell results the increase in atomic size due to inter-electronic repulsion. But because of combined effect of these two contradictory property, the result is once atomic size is decreasing and then increasing or showing such fluctuation. Now we can say, why is atomic volume a periodic property but density is not a periodic property? Atomic volume almost gradual variation shows almost gradual variation down the group or in the periodic table, but density does not. Density shows fluctuation. Let us see with example. Here volume is volume lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. One side I am showing volume. Volume is about 13.1 in cc, and here 23.7, 45.2, 55.8, we can say 56, around 70.1 or 70, around 87. And here density I am giving in gram per cc. Lithium 0.52 approximate gram per cc. Sodium around 0.97 gram per cc. Potassium 0.86 gram per cc. Around 1.9 gram per cc, 1.5 gram per cc. Here around 1.9 gram per cc. Like that, you see, volume is showing regular change, variation, but density is fluctuating. Lithium is having here 0.52, sodium means once increasing, then decreasing, potassium 0.86, again increasing. This kind of fluctuation is there in the property of density of elements. So atomic volume is a periodic property, but atomic density is not a periodic property. This is the reason. That's all for today. Again, next class I will tell you another topic.